hopefully it's not too much of a disturbance. So as you can see, we have got Spookle on the screen, one of my favourite quiz websites to go to. When the pandemic first hit the UK back in the beginning of 2020, I spent quite a bit of time on Spookle and found a newfound love for geography. I learned quite a bit about the countries of the world, some flags, some capital cities, things like that, and really started to enjoy geography. And so I thought in this video, why not put two of my passions together, ASMR and geography. So I've signed up to Spookle under the ASMR Simplified user handle. And I remember when I was playing the geography quizzes, I of course went straight off the bat and learnt the countries of the world. Now, according to Spookle, there are 197 countries, and you apparently can reel them all off in 20 minutes. I haven't actually played any Spookle geography quizzes or Spookle for probably about a year or so, so I will be very rusty on going back to countries of the world. So I thought for this video, or at least some of this video, we would start off with just one continent and see how many countries I can remember from that continent. And I thought, since I'm from the UK, we're going to start with countries of Europe. So I'm hoping that this will be not finding the countries, but actually listing them off. So it says we've got 8 minutes here. I'm going to change that to the stopwatch, just purely because I'm trying to learn everything again. And there's 47 countries in Europe. I've also got a drink of lemonade to the side of me, so I'm probably going to be sipping that throughout the video as well. So, let's just first see if this is going to let me name them and not just point to them or click for them. Okay, perfect. So, we're going to start off with Iceland. Then we're going to go down to the UK. Across the channel, you've got France with Spain underneath. Andorra is in between France and Spain. And then to the left of Spain, you've got Portugal. Then coming back up again, there's Belgium, Netherlands, small country in between them is Luxembourg. Then you've got Germany, Denmark, and we'll go up again. So then you've got Norway. Next to that is Sweden. Russia. Coming down a bit, there's Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania. Lithuania. Spelling may be interesting here. I remember when I was learning it and I knew some of the countries, but I didn't know how to spell them. Belarus and Poland. Then you've got Czechia, which is now independent from Slovakia. That big country next to Poland, Slovakia and Belarus is of course Ukraine. Then you've got Moldova. Then the next country, the big country underneath Moldova, I believe is Romania. Just waiting for my PC to catch up. Romania. Then to the left of Romania is Hungary. Then you've got Austria. There's Switzerland. And the little dot in between Switzerland and Austria is Liechtenstein. Stein, is it? Is it IE at the beginning? Yep, it is. Oh, I forgot. Monaco in France. So the big boot is obviously Italy, and in Italy you have got more, not Moldova, you've got San Marino and Vatican City. There's a small island to the south of Italy called Malta. Would love to go there. Back up again, next to Italy, you've got Slovenia. Croatia is the interesting shaped country. I hope this is actually big enough for you guys. Can we make this any bigger? Let me just zoom in a little bit. Oh, that's too far. Should we go for this? There we go, that's a bit better, I think. Right. Then we've got Serbia sits slightly in the middle. Bulgaria, Greece, a big one is Turkey, and the island below it is Cyprus. Okay, I'm doing quite well here actually. I didn't think I was going to make this. Oh, that's interesting, so they've actually used the new name for Turkey. So I've got five more. I've got Albania, if I couldn't spell it right. Albania, Bosnia and Herzegovina. Perfect. Good remembering on the spelling there. North Macedonia. Kosovo, and the last one is Montenegro. Ah, brilliant. I wasn't expecting to get 100% on that for my first go. Okay, so perhaps in future videos we'll split this up and we'll do all the continents, so I won't do another continent today. Shall we try for another random geography quiz and make this a bit of a geography video? What's this about the Angola quiz? I wouldn't have a clue about that. Okay, let's just go to geography a second. start off with. I am going to do some skipping, I think, because there is a time limit. Netherlands is Amsterdam. Croatia is Zagreb. Slovenia, I think, is that Slovenia, the one with a name I can't actually pronounce. Where is it? Where is it? Ljubljana. Ireland is Dublin. Malta is Valletta. Belgium would be Brussels. Sweden is Stockholm. Norway is Oslo. Belarus is Minsk. Vatican City is Vatican City. San Marino is San Marino. Those ones are a lot easier. Switzerland, I think, is Bern. Albania is... Albania... I probably would remember. Like, if you told me, I'd be like, yeah, it might be Pristina, but let's pass for now. Italy is Rome. Czechia is Prague. Moldova, I'm going to pass. Slovakia. Slovakia is Bratislava, that's it. Serbia is... Where is it? Belgrade. Austria is Vienna. Andorra is Andorra. Portugal is Lisbon. Lithuania. So... you've got Riga, I think it's Latvia, or Lithuania, I'm going to pass it. Spain is Madrid, there's Latvia, let's leave that a second. Monaco is Monaco, Greece is Athens, Kosovo, pass, Turkey is... Turkey, I know this. Nicosia. But then what is Cyprus? Is Cyprus Ankara, that's it. Cyprus is Nicosia. Hungary is Budapest. Russia is Moscow. Liechtenstein is... pass on that a second. Ukraine is, of course, Kiev. France is Paris. I'm running out of time, so I'm going to have to hurry up. Bulgaria is Sofia. Copenhagen for Denmark. Germany is Berlin. Iceland is Reykjavik. Poland is Warsaw. Romania is Bucharest. Finland is Helsinki. United Kingdom is London. Estonia is Tallinn. Luxembourg is Luxembourg. Cyprus is Nicosia. Montenegro, Bosnia and Herzegovina. Where's Albania gone? Albania is Tirana. Okay, let's... Riga is Latvia. Kosovo, I don't know. Liechtenstein, I think is this one. No, it's not Liechtenstein, it's... Do I not get to now choose Liechtenstein? No, okay. I think Vadaz is Liechtenstein. Pristina is... No. Okay, Montenegro. Bosnia and Herzegovina. No. Moldova. Okay, 91%. Average score is 72, so not bad. So I got 4 wrong. So, Sarajevo is the Bosnia one. But this is Liechtenstein. That's what I said. Too late, though. That's Lithuania and Skopt. Ah, yeah, okay. Cool, yeah. Right. I think we'll do European flags now. looks like that. I'm going to have to come back to that one. That's, of course, the UK. Then we've got Turkey. That's Czechia, I think. Yep. Sweden. That is Slovakia. No, it's Serbia. Yep. Switzerland. One of my favourite flags. This is Netherlands. That's Slovakia, right? Yep, okay, cool. Norway. Trying to throw me off with the islands there. Throw me off the scent. Slovenia. Poland. Is that Montenegro or Moldova? Let's try Montenegro. No. Moldova. What is that? I don't know. Let's come back to that one. Ireland. That is. Is that Lithuania? Yep. Then we've got. Is that Finland? Because it's a very strange country layout. No. Oh, Greece. Of course, Greece with their many islands. That should be Luxembourg. Iceland, Kosovo, one of the easiest flags to remember because the shape of it is the shape of their country. That should be Austria, I think. No, it's not Austria. What is that? How is that not Austria? Is that... Is that not Austria? I'm confused. What other countries have a red and white flag? Austria. Okay, we'll come back to that one again. This is Finland. Another easy flag there for Cyprus. That's Belgium. landscape. This is more Dover. Germany. Albania. Interesting flag that is. There's Spain. That is... Why have I got a blank on what that is? Oh, it's Ukraine. How can I have a blank on that? The flag's everywhere. Right, so back to these again. What countries have I not done? Done Montenegro, done, I've done Moldova. I've done Malta. Monaco. Monaco, of course. I haven't done Liechtenstein. So next time we'll some other geography quizzes. There was a guy on YouTube that I used to watch who did logic puzzles, which were really good. Countries that go in each box using both trivia and logic. A pandemic logic quiz. So if you look here, just as an example, I think it is a minefield. So basically, you get given clues about what might go into the other boxes. Is this trivial? Let's give it a quick go, just so you can see what it's like. And then let me know in the comments if you want me to do more of them. So we'll play this. So it says India. Each country in column C is the most populated in its row and on its continent. So each country in column C is the most populated in its row and on its continent. Which doesn't help me find the next clue, does it? Because India is the most popular. Each country in column C, okay, is the most populated. Oh, okay, right. So, India is in Asia, and the most populated country in Asia is China. There you go. I don't think I'm going to get very far on these. Let me just... What we'll do is we'll just zoom in a little bit, and then when we get kicked off because we'll get a question wrong, we'll end the video there. So Suriname is in F4. Suriname is in F4, and Bahrain is not in this quiz. Right, so Suriname is, so that means that C4, I think, so column C is the most populated in its row and on its continent. In its continent. So that must mean this is a South American country, the most populated, which has to be Brazil. Yes. So let's go back to this other clue. A unique continent defines each row. Well, we've worked that out already. And each row only contains countries on that continent. Well, we know that too. Right, Morocco is in A2. So this is Morocco. Which means that this row is African countries. So we've got Asia, Africa and South America so far. And Iceland is at B3. Okay. And then this is the European row. And the most, here's the trick question though, because Russia is in Europe and Asia, and Russia would be the most populated country in Europe. So by definition, this should be Russia. But it might trick me and put Russia in the Asian row. Let's come back to that then. Morocco, Canada is adjacent to Brazil. So Canada must be down here, because if it's adjacent, no, okay, right, let's give it another go, because now I'm intrigued. So this is China. This is Suriname. Making this Brazil. And then Morocco's here. And Iceland is here. Canada is adjacent to Brazil. Oh, so Canada could be in B5 or D5. Because Actually, this has got to be USA, right? The most populated. Yeah, okay. Okay, so is this going to be Russia? What's the most populated country in Africa? It's Nigeria, right? Yes. And the most popular... It's got to be Russia, but I really don't want to chance it. Okay. United States of America. Every country in column B except one is an island nation. Every country in column B except one. Iceland is an island nation. Okay. But there's one that's not. Canada's either here or here. Right, there are two. There are exactly two countries in this row that start with M. So Morocco's the first one. Okay. Every four-letter country from the Americas is in this quiz. Right. Every four-letter country from the Americas. So, that means that... What Americas have got four letters? Peru. Peru's got to be here somewhere. Cuba. Does that count? And Cuba's an island nation. I'm just going to put Russia here. Okay. Two United countries are in column D. So we've got all of our most populated countries now. And we also know the continents that all of them are in. There are exactly two countries in this row that start with M. So what other countries in Africa start with M? Quite a few. We've got Madagascar, we've got Malawi, Mozambique, there's loads. Two United countries are in column D. Two United countries are in column D. This is still relaxing for you guys, even though it's wrecking my brain trying to work this out. We're coming up to 36 minutes of recording now. I think if I don't make it to the next clue, and we get timed out, then I will end the video, and we might have to come back to this quiz. Or you guys could just let me know the answers in the comments. Okay, so we've got European countries. Ah, what does it? Two United countries are in column D. Well, you've got United Arab Emirates and the UK. There isn't anything else, is there? Is this going to be? There's no United in Africa. There's no United in South America. The only United in North America is the United States. This has got to be UAE then, hasn't it? Yes. Each column has just one country that begins with the letter of its column. Okay. So, we haven't got an A yet. We haven't got a B. We've got a C for China. There's no D. But there's also no D. There's no D in South America. There's no country beginning with D. So the D has to either be Djibouti or... No, is there a D in North America? I don't think there is. Let's just come back to that a second though. Three countries in row five have a capital that ends with city. So you've got Mexico City, Panama City, and I don't know what the third one is. So what countries start with E? Eritrea, Egypt, quite a few. Ecuador, it could be. This has got to be Djibouti. Yes. If Finland is in this quiz, then so is El Salvador. Okay, that's not helpful. What else is there? Every four-letter country from the Americas. So Cuba. Wait. Cuba. Doesn't that mean that Cuba's got to be here? Because it's an island nation. Okay. Yes. Which puts Canada here? Because it's next to Brazil. Only one island nation in this row, which is Cuba, so we've done it. The only one syllable country starting with S is in this quiz, but it's not adjacent to Suriname. The only one syllable country. Spain, is that one syllable? Sudan is not. Senegal, Somalia, none of those ones. Is Spain one syllable? If it's not adjacent to Suriname, then this has got to be Spain. Oh, I don't think I'm right here. Here I go. Oh, I am right. All South American countries appear in alphabetical order. Right. So, it said somewhere here about three countries in row five have a capital that ends with city. So these are the three. And all South... Oh, this is North, right? All South American countries appear in alphabetical order. So what sits before Brazil in South America? You've got Argentina. You've got Bolivia. Ecuador. Peru. Uruguay. Guyana. Right, so this has got to be Argentina. And Bolivia, I would guess, but let's come back. An O country can be found at either F1 or E3. F1 or E3. There isn't a country in Europe with an O. So the only O countries that I'm aware of are Oman and nothing else. So we've got to go for Oman. Yeah. No country with more than four words in its name is in this quiz. Okay, that's not helpful. This has got to then be Bolivia, right? Is there another A? Okay, there's seven countries in South America. So you've got Argentina, Bolivia, Brazil, Colombia, Ecuador, Peru, Chile. I said seven. I meant nine, I think, didn't I? Oh, I'm not sure now. I've lost. This has got to be Bolivia. Yes, if Guatemala is in this quiz, then so is Madagascar. It's Guatemala in the quiz. Guatemala City. Yes. Guatemala City is in this quiz. Ah. So this is Madagascar then. Panama is in the same column as Togo. So Togo sits on one of these. Which means that Panama sits on one of these. That's not helpful right now. Okay, what else have we got? Guatemala citizen quiz. There are exactly two countries in this row that start with M. Well, we've got them both here already. If Finland's in this quiz, and so is El Salvador. El Salvador is not in this quiz. What was the one so beginning with Oceania isn't in this quiz. You've got Finland, which is not in this quiz because El Salvador isn't. And you've got, what's the other F? Another F. Is there an F in? Is it? It's got to be France, right? Yes. The world's most southern reaching country is in D4. Southern reaching, meaning Chile, right? Mexico is in the same diagonal line as Kyrgyzstan. Kyrgyzstan. So Mexico is either here, because Kyrgyzstan could be there, or Mexico is there. That's not helpful. What else have we got? Can I complete this? Every country in column B is an island nation except one. Right, so what island nations have we got? Because Bolivia is not an island nation. So what island nations have we got for Asia? Three countries in row five. We know that it's Guatemala City, Mexico City, and Panama City. We know that Mexico City cannot be here, and we know that Panama cannot be here. What other countries? Panama is in the same column as Togo. Can Togo be in either of these? I'm not sure. Suriname is in F4. Right, let's just go through them again. Column C is the most populated in its row. Got that. Canada is adjacent to Brazil. We've got that. All South American countries appear in alphabetical order. Yeah, well, there's a lot of other countries that can go between C and S, so that's not helpful. And no country can be found in. Yeah, we've got that. Panama, we don't know. Every four letter country from the Americas in this quiz. Four letter country from the Americas. Well, that's just Cuba. Oh no, Peru. Peru's got to go here. Yes. Two of the three four-letter African countries are in this quiz. Three four-letter African countries. What? Togo and Chad. We haven't got an E. What E should we have? But if two of the three four-letter African countries are in this quiz, this cannot be Egypt, because we need both of these to be four letters. So Mexico and Guatemala, so it's not any of those either. What E's are in Asia? Oh, I'm a bit confused here. That doesn't make any sense to me. Oh, I haven't got much time. And I'm almost at 50 minutes of this video. I hope that this records and uploads, okay? No country has more than four words in its name. Right, I'm just gonna have to just hazard a guess that this is Panama. Okay. Right, and it's not gonna tell me. Try again, but don't put this country here this time. Okay? Right. Well, we didn't do too badly. The average score is 26%, and we did get to 73. I knew what these lines, what these rows needed, but I didn't know what order. Okay. Well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this slightly different video. Please leave a comment down below what you liked, what you didn't like, and please hit the like button and subscribe